Hi guys, my name is Dries Ketels, I'm an artist, and in this video we will cover 10 or 11 or more, depending on how you count, ideas to do exhibitions without gallery representation. So let's dive in. The first one is an alternative ID, and you see it popping up like mushrooms all over the place now. It's the idea of art vending machines. And there are several artists doing that, several communities doing that. And it's basically a vending machine, perhaps an old cigarettes vending, whatever thing that they transform into a machine that can vend art or sell art. Now, the beautiful thing about it is that it's very cheap. You don't have a lot of overhead costs. You don't have to hang big works and do a lot of transportation of big works. And it's fairly automatic. You don't even have to be there to sell the art. So it's a really cool trick that you can use yourself, or just go into a community that already does that. And the beautiful thing about this is I have seen vending machines selling out in less than a day. So this is a real opportunity that you could grab. The second one is also an alternative ID, and it's popping up. Some artists are doing that, and it's the idea of the moving art show, where artists transform a van or whatever into a museum that they can travel from city to city to city to. There's even a critic who did something similar as well, where she would go from city to city to city, interviewing artists and getting their story around their art. Now, you could even upgrade this whole thing. You could even do it better by, for example, and this is something I didn't see anybody doing yet, so if you want, you can just do that, by making sure that there is place for two people in your van, two exhibitions, so that you can invite an artist from every city that you go to go exhibit with you. Now, the benefit there is that you have a networking opportunity, plus those artists, like, they will invite collectors and artist friends and all of that stuff that could potentially also buy your work. And so there's an upgrade, a network upgrade that's going on there. That might be a really cool way for you to start your art career, or even in mid-career, whatever. The third idea is self-hosting your show. Now, what you're gonna do, or what you want to do, is you could potentially rent a place in a gallery. There are galleries who are doing that. That's cool. But you could also just go to a big art city and search for a place that is empty or being sold at that moment, a storefront that you could potentially use. Now, you want that place to be located in a high foot traffic street or something. A lot of like places where they sell stuff that's a house that is being sold, where they previously sold stuff, are in those locations. Now, if you're going to the owner of that particular property and you say, hey, I want to have an exhibition here, they're gonna say no. So here's what you should be doing. You have to provide value and really step into their shoes to understand what they're trying to do. And you're gonna sell it as follows. You're gonna say, hey, I can help you sell this property faster by inviting high net worth individuals to look at your property. The way I'm gonna do that is by organizing an exhibition there of my art. I can give you an artwork or two in return for your location, and invite collectors who have money, who are familiar with investing, to come to my show, and they will in return also see your property and perhaps know somebody who is interested. Now, if you frame it like this, those people, those property owners, actually see the benefit, and this is a really cool opportunity for them. Investors looking at their property with a glass of wine and enjoying themselves. That's how they want their property to be seen as well. So this is a really cool thing that you could be using. Now, if you're a little bit uncertain about the ability for you to sell your work when you're fully organizing it yourself, which is completely understandable, it's not that easy, then I would recommend to check out some of my videos on selling fine art, so that you can be more comfortable with that and perhaps take this opportunity. Now, you have to understand that these self-hosting opportunities can be really lucrative. When I was exhibiting during the Friese Art Week in London with the other art fair, there was a guy who rented out a place for 1 month, and in literally a couple of days, he already made $8,000. Now, he rented it, I don't remember exactly anymore, like I think about $2,000-$3,000. And it was not even located in a high foot traffic street. It was kind of hidden behind our building, which was really not an easy place to find. And on top of that, the guy didn't have an insane track record. He has on Instagram 300 followers. The guy is not an insane artist, but what happens on those events is that people, collectors, who don't really know that much about art necessarily, they want to brag with their friends. They want to say like, yeah, this piece, I bought this during the Frieze Art Week in London. You know, that's what they want to say. They don't want to, I don't know, explain the painting or anything. You also have those people walking there. And so if you do the timing right, with the right location, this can be a really lucrative way to exhibit. The fourth idea that I want to share with you guys is exhibiting in alternative spaces, like furniture shops or retail stores or flower shops or your local theater building or restaurants. Those are all good places. Like I showed my work in a Michelin star restaurant. Now, you have to know those restaurants, they have to renew their interior every year or every 2 years to satisfy their customers. So for them, it's a win-win situation because then they don't have to do research on artists and find artists and search and et cetera, et cetera, et cetera. And they can have art hanging in their new space or new renovated, like little bit changed space for free. And you can show your works. Those are all really cool ways. Now, the important thing about this, and this is so crucial, most artists have work hanging in their studio for nobody to see. And this is the most stupid thing that you can do as an artist. Those works are salespeople on themselves. They can sell themselves. They can market you as an artist as long as they're hanging on walls. And so it's important to push them out. Perhaps not in an exhibition with a gallery, but just push them out. This is a really important thing for you to do. But anyway, let's go to the fifth way of doing so. Juried exhibitions, juried art shows, or juried competitions. Now, this is a really dangerous one. Why? Because, truth be told, most juried exhibitions and competitions and all of that stuff, they are not in there to help artists. Most of them want to get money from submission fees. Most of them want to actually make a profit on the submissions of artists themselves. They don't really invite collectors or have a network or have an inside foot in the art world that can help you out. And so you have to do real research there. Scan the panel members for their quality. And also, if they are interested in your type of art, if they are not interested in that type of painting, then you have no chance. You have no chance of winning. I once participated in the Painting of the Year competition in my country. And first I was selected, then I was invited for a show. Eventually, I got the 8th place. Now, looking back, I didn't do a lot of research there. I was in my younger years. Looking back, I could have known that I had no chance to win because it was an abstract artwork. And in all the previous years, there was no abstract artwork that was ranked higher than 8th place. None. And all the panel members, they didn't really like abstract artworks that much. And so I didn't really have a chance of winning that in the first place. But I didn't really do a lot of research there, I guess. But anyway, I've won several competitions in my life, but in the last couple of years, I didn't apply to any of them anymore for a reason. And so you really have to think this through. Is this something beneficial for your career, depending on your goals, etc.? This might not be the best option for you. Let's go to the sixth one, Airbnb. Airbnb is a real opportunity, especially now. Let me explain you why, because this might actually be the best one of this list. But first things first, one of the reasons this is a really good opportunity is because people can, instead of looking at your art in a gallery or looking at your art on a website or whatever, actually live with your art. This is an opportunity you don't get in galleries. In this scenario, people live, get familiar with your art, and see how their opinion changes over days. Plus, it's connected to, hopefully, a really nice experience for them. Vacation or whatever. Now, what you want to do here is, of course, hang your work, lay down business cards. You could also potentially go for upsales, like prints that are on a discount because they choose to stay at that place. You can sell your work and share the profits or give 20% of the profits to the homeowner, stuff like that. But the real reason why this is so powerful is the following. And in order to understand this, we have to first look at what happened in the hotel world, because the best practices in the hotel business will be repeating themselves in Airbnb. Why? Because they're tried and true best practices. And so what we saw at a sudden moment in that hotel business type of world, especially in the big art cities, was that hotels started to market themselves as art hotels. Why? Because they wanted to niche down and then be the best hotel within that niche of being an art hotel. You see that in Paris, New York, London, all of those places. And especially during the big art events like Art Basel Miami, for example, you have several hotels, not loose, like just several who have exhibitions going on and invite curators and have whole art events within their hotel and marketing themselves as such. Now, before I recorded this video, I went on Airbnb, searched all the apartments, all the options in London, and there was nobody marketing themselves as an art apartment or an art business location or whatever. Nobody. Mark my words. 10 years from now, that's not going to be the case anymore. Why? Because these are best practices in business. It's just good to niche down and then be the best at what you're doing in that niche. And so this is something that will happen now. If you do it now, you can be the first and do it when there's no saturation. 10 years from now, that will not be the case anymore. And so how are you going to present this to a property owner? Very simple. Explain this business principle. Niche down, connected to a hotel industry, stuff like that, and provide value. Like, I can take pictures, professional pictures, edited by an artist of your property that will make sure that your landing page converts better, stuff like that, and I can share a part of the profit with you, etc., etc., etc. These are real opportunities. And if the owner wants to market himself as an art place, you're certain that almost all people who will come there will be art-related, and this is a real branding opportunity. Okay, we're getting to the end of this video. The 8th way to getting your work seen, having an exhibition, is an illegal way. But it's a way that works extremely well. And it's very simple. You just go to a famous museum or an art fair or whatever, and you hang your work on the wall. You hack that museum. There are a lot of artists who've done that in the past, and they got huge press coverage in return for that and other things that came their way. But it's a pot that I would not necessarily recommend. It's an illegal pot. So that's a thing that you could be doing, and it could be very beneficial for you. Now, the 9th way is a little bit trickier in that you're not really going to have an exhibition in the short term, but you're going to have huge opportunities for exhibitions in the long term. And it is creating art shows. Going to galleries who are open for curators and creating a show for them. And you're going to take part of their work and do that for free, basically. Now, the benefit of this, or there are several benefits of this. Number one, you're going to understand the perspective of a curator more, therefore connect with them more, and they you will appreciate them in a real way, and they will feel that, and therefore perhaps want to work with you in the future. Number two, you will be able to show your punctuality and business talent to the gallery owner without pushing your art, without presenting your art and like, here, I'm an artist, whatever. No, just by providing value, which is something that they really, really like. And number three, all those participating artists They will feel and value the thing that you do for them, and therefore in return, some of them in the future will invite you for group shows and stuff like that. And so that's where that exhibition opportunity starts to take place. And on top of that, you can also make a profit, because traditionally 50% will go to the artist, 40% to the gallery, and 10% to the curator in that scenario. So this is a really cool way to connect with galleries, to connect with artists, and provide value in that community. Now, the last one for this list is a little bit strange. Number 10 is also an alternative one. It's letting your creativity rule. And here's what most people think when they're thinking about exhibitions. They're thinking about a building with walls where they can hang their stuff, and that's not necessarily the case. You can use anything you want. You can use the rainforest, the desert, the North Pole, whatever you want. You can, like, for example, JR. He did an exhibition at the Palestinian and Israeli border. Those two countries are in war with one another. They're fighting. That border is normally used for shooting people. He did the biggest illegal photography exhibition, open air exhibition right there, connecting those two countries for a moment there with one another. That's beautiful. That's amazing. And you get... he probably got some real publicity there as well. I could do a whole video on that creation on itself. It's just amazing artist, amazing creation. But there are a lot of those examples out there. Prada, for example, they had their shop in the middle of the desert. Nowhere. Nobody came there. The only reason that they did that probably is get some free publicity. And they got a lot of free publicity for that, which made their investment worthwhile. Like, there's a lot of opportunity there. There are even artists who put their art in space. There are several artworks orbiting this planet as we speak, and probably many more to come. The Orbital Reflector, for example, is one of those. A $1.5 billion project. Now, you're not gonna do a $1.5 billion project. That's not what I'm aiming at, but you can let your creativity go. You know, an exhibition in the middle of the desert with you alone waiting for people to come could be kind of funny. Like, why I'm sharing this 10th one is just to let you know that everything's possible. And with the internet now and all of that publicity, all of that PR that you can do there, any location can do, as long as you make it worthwhile. Do whatever you want. That's kind of the closing statement. Do whatever you want if you think it's creative. You can like, comment, subscribe, or none of those things. It's all within your possibility. Take care. I hope this video helped. And I'll see you later. Ciao, 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 ciao.